Do you remember the first time that you verbalized or became aware that you wanted to be a sculptor rather than a painter?
Well, I was going to say, for me, the distinctions are not that important. Nevertheless, there was one instance when I went to the library with another little girl in my class. And I recall the librarian, who was quite a cultivated lady, said to the little girl, "What are you going to do when you grow up?" as they always ask. And I think the little girl said she was going to be a stenographer or a bookkeeper. And I don't know, but I had time while she was asking her questions, and I looked around. And in this library that Carnegie gave to the city was this great, big Joan of Arc. It was a sitting figure, and it was made out of white plaster, and it had a little patina. And I looked at that, and instinctively, if I can use that word, I knew right away what it meant. And then she asked me what I was going to do, and I said, "I'm going to be an artist." And before I finished, I said, "No, I'm going to be a sculptor. I don't want color to help me." And I think that is the key to my life. That has been the key. That why I chose the hard way, I don't know. But that is really as important for me to tell you that as if I really expounded on philosophy from now till doomsday.
That's very interesting, especially in view of the fact that the objects which you use, the forms which you use in your work, are found objects, many of which have had a previous existence, come to you with different patinas, colors, and age, and you eradicate all of that
with one cleansing color.
Yes.
Well, now let me explain. I think that's a wonderful thing you asked me. I was doing these things, and I painted them, as you know, one color. For me, black isn't black anyway, and color isn't color as such. Color is a rainbow, and it's just as fleeting as anything on earth, you see, if you want to analyze it. And every minute is changing through light. So it's a mirage. So let's get there right away. Now, the important thing is that someone, an artist, came to the house, and they wanted to be nice to me, and they said, "Why don't you use, say, a little Indian red here? And why don't you use a little white here? And it'll make, you know, something this and that." And I said, "I'm not making anything. And I don't want to do that. Because my whole life has been centered." You can use the word self-center if you wish. I think it's a great word. Who am I going to center myself on if not on my inner self? We were talking about color and that
and
I make nothing.
And being self-centered.
I said about the color that I didn't want to use because of that. Yes, I feel that we'll diverse a little and come right back to where we started.
Okay.
When people say that I'm a strong woman, it offends me no end because I don't want to be a strong woman. All I want is to reveal what I understand about the world to myself, and that is my whole search. And my whole, not only search, because I'm not searching, but I want it to be revealed to me. And for that, I work. And for that, I will work more. Because that's all I want. Now, when we were saying, for instance, about the color of the little white here and the little, I have not done things for the outside. I have done things because I want to see clearer. But I mean, that can sound stupid if people don't understand what I'm talking about. But in every human being, there is the potential of greatness. For instance, if I say that in religion, now I'm not talking about religion as such, but I am talking about the wise people that have given us books that have great wisdom. And when they say, for example, that we are created in the image and likeness of God. Now, if you don't live up to your greatest potential, then you are cheating God. So who are you cheating? You are cheating the God within yourself. And I want a total being of myself. I feel rich enough in myself and that I can pay that price. And that is why I work. And I hope, as long as I'm here, that that's the way I will work.
It's interesting because knowing you as well as I do and for as long as I do, I've come to realize that the works of art that you've made are not the total work of art, that the life is the total work of art, and these are tangible manifestations of that totality. And I see it in everything you do. I see it in the collage aesthetic, or this kind of building to reveal images, in the way you dress, in the predilections of what you want to do. Have you been aware your whole life of that kind of totality, of specifically how easily it's seen in your clothing?
I am totally aware, yes. Because you see, again, what probably has given me my vision is that I have not been caught in cliches. When I was growing up, it was fashionable, if you were pretty, to say, well, she's pretty, beauty is skin deep. Well, beauty is not skin deep, beauty is beauty. In other words, I would like to say that the whole thing that we're talking about has one note in my life, as you can see, and that is the important thing to me. Now, another thing, let us take Beethoven, just because everyone knows Beethoven. And we're talking about his time and in the Occidental world. Now, we have octaves in music, and that's eight notes and then some half notes. And out of eight notes, he built a world of sound. All the things that he created are really out of eight notes. Now, those eight notes go higher, an octave higher, octave lower, but there are only eight notes in an octave. Now, I only need one note, and that is my note of consciousness. And that is what I want more of, my own consciousness.